हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज ट्रांसक्रिप्शन इन प्रोकैरियोट्स।
ट्रांसक्रिप्शन इन प्रोकैरियोट्स,
दिस इज एन इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक फॉर यूनिवर्सिटी एग्जामिनेशन। यू मे गेट एलएक्यू एज वेल एज एसएक्यू फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक, एंड लॉट ऑफ एमसीक्यूज आर फ्रीक्वेंटली आस्क फ्रॉम दिस टॉपिक। सो दिस इज एन इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक फॉर एग्जाम प्रिपरेशन। We'll discuss this topic under the heading of definition, what is the role of RNA polymerase, different units of RNA polymerase, then what do we mean by template, what do we mean by promoter region, and what is requirement for the transcription to proceed, and various steps in the transcription process, that is initiation, elongation and termination. Okay, so what do we mean by transcription? It is a synthesis of RNA from a DNA molecule. Suppose this is a DNA molecule. By the process of transcription, this DNA molecule is converted into RNA, and then RNA by the process of translation, it is converted into specific protein. This is known as central dogma of molecular biology. So formation of RNA from DNA is known as transcription. Now, how this transcription process differs from replication process? So, in this transcription process, only a part of DNA act as a template. What do you mean by template strand? It is a strand of DNA molecule which act as a mold for the synthesis of new RNA molecule in a specific and organized way. That is known as template DNA strand. Okay, only part of DNA act as a template, while in replication both the strands, they act as a template for the synthesis of new DNA molecule. Here main enzyme of transcription is RNA polymerase, while in DNA synthesis the main enzyme is DNA polymerase. Multiple primers are required in the new strand synthesis in the replication, while here no primer is required. The nucleotides in the transcription are ribonucleotides, nucleotide triphosphates, and in RNA the nucleotide is uracil in place of thymine. So ATP, GTP, CTP and UTP will be there in place of thymidylate, uridylate will be there. Okay, this is transcription, synthesis of RNA from the DNA molecule. Now, what is RNA polymerase? It is a main enzyme in the transcription process. It is DNA dependent RNA polymerase composed of core enzyme plus one protein, that is known as sigma factor. RNA polymerase, it is composed of core enzyme plus sigma factor, that is known as holoenzyme. Okay, now this core enzyme, it is composed of beta prime, 2 alpha and omega unit, and this together is known as holoenzyme. So 2 beta units will be there, 2 alpha units will be there, 1 omega and sigma factor. So what is the role of beta unit? It is for polymerization. It has polymerase activity, causes 3 prime 5 prime phosphodiester linkage formation, polymerization. This beta prime, it has helicase activity, which is required for the unwinding of DNA molecule. Okay, then this alpha, it recognizes the DNA to be transcribed into RNA. Region of DNA to be transcribed into RNA. Okay, and what is the role of sigma? Scans the DNA molecule recognizes the promoter region and helps RNA polymerase to sit on that promoter region. Means it helps in the binding of RNA polymerase, binding of RNA polymerase to the promoter region. So these are the different units of RNA polymerase. You may get BAQ, brief answer question of 2 marks on the structure and functions of different units of RNA polymerase. Got it? It has 2 beta, 2 alpha. So beta, beta prime, 2 alpha units and 1 omega unit and sigma factor. So this is the structure of RNA polymerase. Now what do you mean by promoter region? What is template? And how RNA polymerase works, we'll see. Suppose this is a DNA molecule. This is one strand. This is another strand. So it is in 3 prime to 5 prime direction. And this one is 5 prime to 3 prime direction. This is plus 1. This is known as transcription start site. The actual site from which transcription will start. This is known as transcription start site. This is a region of DNA which is actually transcribed into RNA. This region is a region of DNA which is actually transcribed into RNA. This is plus 1 means this is a transcription start site. Now to the upstream of this site, from on this side, it is known as upstream. And to this side, it is known as downstream. It is represented by the minus sign while it is represented by the plus sign. So the base pair to the left of this transcription start site, it is known as upstream elements. While to the right of this transcription start site, it is known as downstream elements. Okay. Now there is a region in the minus 10 base pair region. Okay. The sequence on the coding strand, this one is the coding strand. This one is the template strand. Template strand here in the 3 prime, 5 prime direction. Template strand, it acts as a mold, it acts as a strand for the synthesis of new RNA molecule. That's why it is known as template strand or nonsense strand. Why it is known as coding or sense strand? Because the sequence of mRNA, newly synthesized mRNA, is exactly similar to that of the coding strand. This region of the coding strand only differ in the uracil. The new mRNA molecule will differ in a will have uracil, while this strand will have thymine. This is the only difference. That's why it is known as coding strand. Okay, and to the upstream of this transcription start site, there is a region in the minus 10 base pair with the sequence that is TATAAT. This region is known as Tata box or Pribno box. This is promoter region. This whole unit from the promoter region to the initiation, elongation and termination site is known as transcription unit. And the RNA synthesized from this unit, it is known as primary transcript. Okay. So this minus 10 base pair region, it is known as Tata box or Pribno box. Tata box or Pribno box. And minus 35 region, there is sequence TGTTGACA. This is minus 35 sequence. It is a consensus sequence for RNA polymerase to recognize promoter region. It is initial site for binding of RNA polymerase. Minus 35 region. So this is promoter element. This box is known as promoter element. Okay. So what do you mean by promoter? It is a site on a DNA molecule where RNA polymerase can bind. And what is the role of this minus 35 base pair consensus sequence? It is a initial site for the binding of RNA polymerase. It helps in the recognition of promoter region. So this one is the Tata box. It is a promoter region. Then this is a transcription start site. This blue line indicates the template DNA strand in 3 prime to 5 prime direction. while this opposite strand is known as coding strand. The elements or nucleotide to this side is known as downstream elements, and to this side they are known as upstream elements and represented by the negative sign. Okay. Now ribonucleotides are required for the synthesis of RNA molecule, and RNA polymerase is required. Different units of RNA polymerase, they work together in the process of transcription. So this is requirement for the new RNA synthesis. Now from the DNA molecule, there will be synthesis of mRNA, rRNA and tRNA. Of these we will see the mRNA synthesis. Then steps. There are various steps in the transcription process. So initiation, in the initiation, the first will be formation of closed complex or formation of pre-initiation complex. Initiation complex. Then second step is open complex formation. Then third one is the synthesis of RNA, synthesis of 5 to 10 nucleotides RNA, and fourth one is the promoter clearance. These are the steps in the initiation of transcription. Okay, so initially what happens, this sigma factor of RNA polymerase scans the DNA. Sigma factor scans the DNA, recognizes the consensus sequence, which is minus 35 upstream the transcription start site, and it initially binds to this region of DNA. To the which region? This minus 35 base pair region. And then it stretches itself to bind the promoter region, that is starter box. Okay, so this results in the formation of this is transcription start site, this is starter box, minus 10 base pair upstream, this is minus 35 sequence. So it stretches itself and attaches to the promoter region. This is known as formation of closed complex. Okay. As it binds with the Tata box or promoter element, the opening of the strand occurs. Okay. Local opening of the strand occurs in the region of the Tata box, because it is easy to separate the DNA in the region of TATA rich region as compared to GC rich region. So separation of strand occurs. This is RNA polymerase and this is known as open complex. Open complex. Then there will be start of RNA synthesis. So from the transcription start site, RNA synthesis will occur in 5 prime to 3 prime direction. This strand in 3 prime to 5 prime direction. So in the 5 prime 3 prime direction, nucleotide synthesis will occur. Okay, with the help of polymerase activity of RNA polymerase. So polymerization means what happens? There is addition of nucleotide to the growing 3 prime OH group. Okay. So nucleotide will be added to the 3 prime OH group of the previously added nucleotide. So the stretch of RNA formation occur. Okay. Stretch of RNA of length near about 5 to 10 nucleotides will occur in the initiation. And fourth one is the promoter clearance. After the synthesis of 10 to 20 nucleotides stretch of RNA, that is 10 to 20 nucleotide stretch of RNA, this RNA polymerase physically moves away from this region, physically moves away from this promoter region. Okay, that's why it is known as promoter clearance. Okay, so formation of pre-initiation complex, then formation of open complex, synthesis of RNA molecule and promoter clearance. These are the steps in the initiation of transcription. Now, elongation. In the elongation, three important things. The first one is the polymerization. Polymerization means elongation. Three important steps in the elongation, that is polymerization, then proofreading. Polymerization means 3 prime 5 prime phosphodiester linkage formation. So we'll discuss the elongation process. So in the elongation, there is polymerization, means the 3 prime OH group of previously added nucleotide attacks the 5 prime phosphate of incoming nucleotide, and that results in the 3 prime 5 prime phosphodiester linkage formation. Okay. This causes the elongation of RNA molecule, and the proofreading function of RNA polymerase is very less as compared to the DNA polymerase. One protein, that is protein bridge, helps in the transcription process. Okay. Suppose this is newly synthesized RNA and polymerization is going on. Okay, this is 5 prime end, this is 3 prime end. These are the nucleotides. Okay, and the elongation is going on. So, nucleotide will be added to the 3 prime end. Okay, and one protein, that is protein bridge, allow the template strand, only one nucleotide of template strand, to act as a template for the synthesis of new RNA. So proofreading function will be there by the protein bridge. Okay. So this is known as elongation. Now the termination. Termination, it is of two theories are given for the termination process. The first one is the intrinsic termination. Intrinsic termination, and second one is the rho factor dependent. Rho factor dependent termination. These are the two mechanisms involved in the termination. Okay. So what is intrinsic termination? There are signal in the growing RNA molecule which act as a signal for the termination of transcription process. Okay. So there is region that reach in G and C base pair. So G, C, C, G, C. There is G, C reach region. Due to this G, C reach region, there is hairpin formation because of complementary base pairing, or loop formation because of complementary base pairing, which act as a signal for the termination. And there is poly A in the DNA template strand which results in the U, poly U in the RNA, that triggers the termination, poly U. So these are the two intrinsic signals for the termination process. GC reach segment, formation of hairpin loop, and poly U in the newly synthesized RNA that act as a termination signal for the transcription. Second one is the rho factor dependent. In this rho factor dependent termination, there is one protein that is known as rho protein. This protein, it works in a rotating manner, and this one is a RNA stimulated ATP dependent cofactor, it has helicase activity. RNA stimulated ATP dependent helicase activity, and this protein in the rotating manner will bring about the termination of transcription. This is known as cofactor dependent transcription. So this is all about the transcription process, and there is no post transcriptional modification in the prokaryote in case of mRNA, while tRNA and rRNA goes for the post transcriptional modification. Okay, so these are the steps: initiation, elongation and termination. In the initiation, there is formation of pre-initiation complex, then closed complex, that is also known as closed complex, then open complex formation, local unwinding of the strand, then form synthesis of RNA 5 to 10 nucleotide, then 10 to 20 nucleotide, and then promoter clearance, then elongation in the form of phosphodiester linkage, polymerization with the help of beta subunit of RNA polymerase, somewhat proofreading with the help of protein bridge, and then termination, that is intrinsic and cofactor dependent termination. So this is all about the transcription process in prokaryote. So keep watching. Thank you.